Yeah.
Morning.
Okay, I'm gonna read Romans 11. The 11th chapter. And, no, Romans 12 chapter. I learned that I have to be careful just to open up the Bible and start reading.
Right.
And I say, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your body a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. I read Romans 12, chapter 33.
May God have sent you this ministry by the word.
Amen.
God, your love.
Thank you. said, it's all about Jesus. And look at your neighbor and say, it's all about Jesus.
All about Jesus.
Time for our responsive reading. Second Sunday. First Peter, chapter 4, 7 through 13. But the end of all things is at hand. Be therefore sober and watch unto prayer, people.
And above all things, have every care among yourselves, for charity shall cover the multitudes of sins.
Use hospitality one to another without grudging, people.
As every man has received a gift, even so minister the same one to another, as good stewards of the man for the grace of God.
If any man speak, let him speak the oracles of God. If any man minister, let him do it as of the ability which God giveth. And God in all things may be glorified through Jesus Christ, to whom we praise and dominion forever and ever. Amen. People.
Thank you. wonderful, y'all. Yes. All right, speaking on behalf of Pastor Green and the Mount Emo Church family, y'all, these are our written announcements. You are cordially invited to attend the 40th anniversary celebration of North Brothers Gospel Singers. This is going to be Sunday, August the 18th at 6 p.m. The theme, 40 years of giving God the highest praise. The place will be at the St. Rex Baptist Church. This is at 1664 Gordon Street in Shreveport, y'all. Summer Revival at the Red River Missionary Baptist Church. This is right behind us here, y'all. The host pastor is Donald Worsham, and the guest pastor is Dr. Theron Jackson of the Morningstar Baptist Church. This will be held on August the 12th, 13th, 14th at 7 p.m. night. And the Eastside Baptist Church. The pastor office and members of the Eastside Baptist Church would like to invite you to our church anniversary. This is going to be on Saturday, August the 25th at 2:30 p.m. The special guest will be Brother Francis Houston and the St. Paul Baptist Church. Okay, to the Mount Nebo Church family, every seventh and fourth Sunday, for Wednesday, the youth department will meet at 6:30 p.m. This is from the youth director, y'all. We are asking that you have your children here every second and fourth Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. Okay, Pastor said, if anyone don't have the $250 or the $300 today, we can pay it, well, in other words, it is due in September. And so this is when it is due. All is due in September, y'all. So if you can't pay it today, you pay it, you still got to September. Okay, on our seeking shut-in list, it's Sister Helen Ivory and Sister Shirley Gilson. Is there anyone else? Will our visitors please stand? Amen. Amen. Would you like to introduce yourself in your church home?
Well, I just give all praise to God for being here and most of God seeing me here before. I'm Frederick Branch, like Branch of the Vine, Branch. And right now, I'm moving around my former church. Last time I was here was Freedom Missionary Baptist Church in 2010, Greenwood Road. And one thing I want to point out, since the start of my ministry, since 99, I have been a help and an increase in every church that I've been a member of. I've been led by the Spirit. When I went to Freedom, it was about averaging 9 to 10 people. Now they're averaging about 30, 40 something people. And I've done all that I can do. When I went there, they had no songs in the house. Now they have two songs in the house, even after I'm gone. And I try to be a help wherever I go. I was ordained in 2001 under Bishop Ricky Moore at the time, Dr. Everywhere. I laid to preach Louisiana, Texas, and California. And I just like to be a help in God's service. God called me, money didn't call me, pride didn't call me. It was not me, but it was God. Right. So I try to be humble to God, no matter what man may say. It's about being in service for God. And I see him finish it. My work sometimes may interfere. So all these years, preached at Bethany Church, and I served 8 Sundays at a church that was vacant, but I never been the type of person that right now trying to pastor church. I'm just a servant of God. My original pastor was Dr. George Monroe, and I tried to be submissive to God. A lot of times, I've been to the point that when God bless you, people become upset. And so I try to be at peace. And everywhere I've been to, I went to Sunrise, I was at St. Joe, had an uncle, Pastor Andrew Marshall was up there. I was at Tabernacle Missionary Baptist Church on the Cooper Road, Pastor Adam Jackson. I was under Pastor Rita Taylor and it's the Greater Mount Zion and Vaughan Street. And everywhere I went, there was an increase. So I know God, I was following his will. I'm not a person that calls confusion. And I remember I preached here, like I said once before, and the truth that your pastor had, when God was working on me to leave from Freedom about 3 months ago, he came to my realization that I once preached here and the hospitality at this church and the longevity he has at this church. And so that's why I said I'd come back and visit. But I'm not a person looking for things because I do work. I'm not a home begging preacher. I want you to know that. And I'm not a cutthroat because I was raised in a Christian family with a father who was a preacher and a mother who was dedicated to God and the family. So I just want to let you know that a lot of times people think they call it church hop, but with a preacher, it's different because he's into the vineyard and he's to do the work as God ordered him, not man. A lot of people have stumbled in life worshiping the man more than God. And when you have a relationship with God, you can be refrigerated and do what's right for God. But I just thank God for my being, and I thank him for all things that pastor has continued to be successful. And every church that has blessed me throughout my ministry, I have seen God bless them years later. So I just want to say that it's a blessing to be here with you.
Amen. We're speaking on the Pastor Graham and the entire Mount Nebo Church family. We welcome you here this morning. We're so glad that you came out to praise and worship with us. And we hope something is said and done that will keep you encouraged in Jesus Christ. Again, you are welcome.
Amen. 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 The mission is going to have a meeting after church.
Okay. The mission is going to have a meeting after church. So everyone that's in the mission, don't leave and have a meeting after church.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank God for Reverend Branch, who is with us today. Amen. He is with us today. Thank God for him. Thank God for all of you. Amen. That is him. Truly God has given room to all of us. And he deserves all of our praise.
Yes, he does.
Amen. As people said, this is our casual month. Amen. And we want to let our hair down and give God praise.
Yes.
Amen. How many of y'all give praise? We need God to strengthen us.
Yes.
So we need him to strengthen us.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. How many of you can do that?
Yes.
Amen. 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 And if we just pray and come together.
Yes.
Amen. And that's what it is, to keep coming together. With 2 or 3.
Yeah.
Together in my name. President agree on the same thing. I'll be in
the midst.
Let us touch and agree that God built this church, that God made the church he wanted to be.
Yes.
Amen. 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 Go ahead and give us a break. Give us a break. Give us a break. come on, come on, officers, come on.
Will the choir please stand and walk around to the table, please?
Too much fun.
I can believe it.
Yeah, too much. Yeah.
I love his word.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
That's love his word.
Amen.
Because we are cleansed through the word.
Yeah.
Oh, familiar scripture, Philippians chapter 4. Not that I speak in respect of want, for I have learned. And whatsoever state I am, therewith be content. I know both how to be abased, and I know how to abound. Everywhere in all things I am instructed both to be full and to be hungry. Both to abound and to suffer need. Everybody repeat it out to me.
I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me.
Amen.
I'm going to run and see what
Lord, have mercy. Because I said, why you pray? Why you pray? It comes to teach us that we are never alone. I don't care how dark it gets. I don't care how cloudy it gets. I don't care how rough the storm is. I am never alone. Because it was that I'm never leaving. does he test your faith.
Right.
He tests your dedication. Or you dedicate. How many of you are dedicated to him? When you're dedicated to something, nothing will stop you from it. So if you're dedicated to something, nothing will stop you from that. When you're dedicated to it, a mob rock can't stop you. Talk to me somebody. When you're dedicated to it, praise can't stop you.
All right.
Sometimes, you don't have to do all the exercise, all that running up and down the road, just shut your mouth. And then we complain, oh, I want to do it for you. No, you don't.
All right.
You know what you really want to do it. You know what to do? Shut your mouth.
All right. Okay.
Don't get jealous of me. Because I ain't not a gambler.
And so Come on, y'all, let's be.
Let's reach.
because greed will kill itself. Greed people harm themselves. Just like our president, he harms himself. Being so greedy, he learns how to perfect lying. Bless you.
Bless you. Praise God. In this walk of life, let us rededicate ourselves. Amen. Amen. Make God a vow. Amen. And keep your vow. Amen. Amen. Then get your own mind. Amen. Stop listening to other people and listen to what the Lord is telling you. Amen. God bless you. And God keep you. Are there any announcements before we go? Amen. Let us stand. We want to thank her, Reverend Branch, for coming to worship with us today. Grace God, we come right now. Thanking you for your love and kindness and your tender mercy. Father, thank you for this young man here. Father, we pray you strengthen us. Father, we pray you lead us to where you want us to be. Then, Father, I would pray that you give us the spirit of praise and of worship. A spirit to get in your word and see what you have to say to us. Father, we pray that you miss business from this place. But never not present right now, we pray. Amen. Amen. Amen.